Ooh, what's going on YouTube? Bear here, this is Bear's Mix. Welcome back to my channel. I want to start out by saying Happy New Year to everybody. I hope this new year finds everybody joy and happiness. Lots of great revenue for all my drivers out there. And I hope this year goes much better than last year did. And I also need to say happy birthday to my beard. And I can't believe how white it's gotten in this last year. Just for S&Gs, I completely shaved my goatee and everything off on January 1st last year, 2020, just to see how much my beard would grow in a year. And here we are, 2021, and this is what we got. Anyways, I'm here to give you guys a breakdown, a year in review of driving with Western Flyer Xpress. I'm going to break down my numbers, miles driven, my gross revenue, my total expenses, and my net profit. Now, this is before any taxes. Now, keep in mind, my taxes, including my fuel purchases and other expenses, out-of-pocket expenses, are not... my fuel expenses are reflected in the expense report here, but my out-of-pocket expenses, things like tools, truck washes, cleaning supplies, hotel stays, paid parking for trucking, my satellite XM radio, I had to replace my GPS, I had to replace my laptop, had to get a new dash cam. Those items are not reflected in this. These are items that are out of pocket, stuff that I paid for that were not deducted from my settlements. And yeah, we'll get to all this here right after this brief introduction. All right, guys, welcome back again. This is January 1st, 2021. This is a new year, hopefully a new leaf, and things will turn around and straighten out for this nation in short order. Now, my out-of-pocket expenses. Now, this does include my fuel expenses, so the numbers are going to be off there. Is over $64,000 in out-of-pocket expenses and potential tax deductions. Of course, part of that $64,000 is included in my regular expenses there, but I won't have a complete breakdown for probably another 10 to 14 days until my accountant gets back to me with my P&L, my profit and loss statement for the year. Now, miles driven, I potentially have over $78,000 in tax deductions on miles alone, plus the per diem, which I'm not sure what per diem rate is for this past year. Something I'm still trying to figure out or find out. So that's going to offset a lot of my expenses, my taxes, my mileage, and all my out-of-pocket expenses. I'm going to offset a lot of my taxes. Every quarter I have come up owing zero to the IRS on my quarterly taxes because I take all my allowable deductions. Now, here we go. My miles for the year. Total miles driven from when I got into this truck January 8th, 2020 until December 31st, 2020. Total miles, paid miles was 121,221 miles. Those were my paid miles. Those were my booked miles. Of course, with my taking different routing and going out of route, a few different things. My actual driven mileage is a lot more than that. My actual driven miles is 135,648 miles. Didn't realize I went out of route that much this year, but wow. And of course, that's going to affect my fuel expenses and a few other things down the road. But what I was paid for was 121,221 miles. My gross revenue to the truck for the year came out to $157,302.72. My total expenses on the truck this year are just out-of-pocket expenses. Not out-of-pocket expenses, I'm sorry, deductible expenses. That's my truck payments, my warranty payments, my insurances, all that kind of stuff. Everything that's included in that 317.08 that I told you guys about before. My total expenses out of settlement is $83,313.29, leaving me with a net profit to the truck before taxes of $412. Let me try this again. $57,412.65 is my total profit to the truck. Like I said, I didn't owe anything in taxes this year because I take all my deductions. I keep very accurate and accounting of everything. All my receipts get sent to my bookkeeper. And then as a backup, anytime I get back into the truck, first thing I do before I move my truck after a purchase is I jump here on my phone. I go into my QuickBooks Self-Employed app and I enter all my expenses and anything related to any business related expenses. Get entered into that, things like my cell phone bill, my Wi-Fi hotspot, my Sirius XM radio, the laptop I had to replace, the GPS I had to replace, the dash cam I had to replace. I've actually gone through 3 dash cams this year. The sun, the heat just destroys them down here in the desert. Things like showers, laundry, truck washes, secured parking for the truck when I'm home. That costs me $100 a month for a secured parking space. When I'm on the road, my car stays there. And when I am home, of course, the truck stays there and I take my car home. There are a lot of expenses, a lot of things that are tax deductible, things that you can write off. And you cannot do that as a owner, or rather as a company driver. These are expenses and deductions that are only available to independent drivers and owner operators, such as myself and many of you others out there. Now, also included in my expenses this year is I just started my own brokerage firm, MP Enterprises LLC. I am incorporated and set up as a freight broker in the state of Alaska, where I actually planned on being to by now, but because of the COVID, the closures and everything going on, I haven't been able to hire a team to put in this truck so I can move myself up there. But that's not stopping me from booking loads right now as a freight broker. I can't book for myself. I'm booking for a couple of shippers and a couple of carriers. Those numbers, of course, are not reflected in my numbers here for Western Flyer Xpress. These numbers that I've gotten written down here are just a breakdown going by my settlements, each settlement for the year, and doing the calculations off of that. So yeah, I mean, this year so far, I mean, I've put in my pocket $57,412.65, not including my side hustles. That's not including my web hosting, my online retail stores. I have a retail store set up online for barbecue equipment and supplies. I've got an online retail store set up for homesteading and camping and gardening type stuff. Like I said, there's my web hosting reseller packages, my domain registration services. I've got a few different things going on here, and not including my revenue from YouTube. This channel is not monetized yet. I'm not making any revenue here. But my other channel on getting prepared to move to Alaska and what I tend to go do there with my homesteading and everything, that channel monetized within a month and a half. That channel is already monetized. I've already got over 4,000 watch hours there. I've already got over 2,000 subscribers there. Here I currently have around 1,300 subscribers on this channel and about 1,700 hours of watch time. So I'm nearly halfway to the point where this channel will be monetized as well. And you guys, everybody watching right now, I truly appreciate you. I thank you for being here. If you've gotten any value or any good entertainment and good information from the channel, as I hope you have, please be sure to subscribe and smash that like button. Give me that thumbs up. That's what YouTube wants to see, are the thumbs up. It helps with the internal promotion of the channel. Gets the word out there, gets people looking at the channel. And don't forget to ring the notification bell so you know when I upload new videos, as well as leave a comment below. Ask me your questions, anything you want to know, I will answer for you to the best of my knowledge. I try and keep this everything here very open, very honest, very transparent. I want to give you guys good information representative of what you will actually experience for yourself if you come over here working for Western Flyer Xpress. I've had about a half dozen drivers come into the company after watching my videos. And I'm glad you guys are here. To every single one of you, thank you for coming. I truly appreciate you being here. Now, I guess this video is going to be a little shorter than I normally do, or not. I want to give you guys a little information too on my brokerage. So if anybody out there is an owner operator and you're looking for a broker, or if anybody watching this works for a shipper, and please consider sending some loads my way so I can get some wheels under them and get some freight going and we can keep America moving. I'm going to be brokering all 48 states, Alaska, parts of Canada, and I'm even looking into some of the U.S. territories as well as Hawaii and part of Mexico. I don't speak Spanish, so that's kind of hard to do, but surprisingly, in Canada, only two provinces in Canada regulate brokers and transportation industry, which I found very surprising, but it also opens it up and makes it a lot easier for me to broker loads in and out of Canada. So that's another area I'm looking at expanding into. A little bit about the business here. For those of you that want to know how long it took me to obtain my broker authority, it was exactly 30 days from start to finish. The start was setting up a office, a physical location in Anchorage, Alaska, having an office, having phone lines set up, having fax lines set up, everything set up, and I have a legitimate physical mailing address and physical office in Anchorage, Alaska currently. Then I had to obtain my EIN from the IRS, which is basically the social security number for the business. Then I had to go to Alaska and apply for my entity, set up my corporation. I'm set up as an LLC. Then I had to get my Alaska state business license. I have a license, general business license, good for 2 years. I checked with the borough of Anchorage as well as the city of Anchorage. For this type of work, there is no business license required other than the state general law business license, and it is a business that I can operate from home in Alaska. I can do it as a home-based business if I needed to, which would save me a little bit of money on rent for the office that I'm running right now. All that took about 3 days to get everything set up. Then I got my business bank account. That took another day to get set up. Then I went over and through DAT. Well, first I went to TIA, the Transportation Intermediaries Association. I joined them, got a membership with them, as well as I took their broker training course. Theirs is the only course out there that's actually bona fide and recognized. Many shippers and many carriers are members of TIA. That gives you a upper level of, what's the word I'm looking for here? It shows you're legitimate. it also gives you a little more credibility in the business, being a member of such an association. I'm also a member of the OOIDA, the Owner Operators Independent Drivers Association, and a little bit more there as well as the credibility goes. I am also a registered SmartWay partner, as well as a SITPAT partner, which is the anti-terrorism program as it related to cargo and freight entering and exiting the country. So I'm registered with the federal government on that level as well. I went through DAT to file for my operating authority. I highly recommend anybody who wants to become a broker or a carrier, go through somebody like DAT, a company that's been doing this for years and does this type of work exclusively, to make sure you don't get stuck with any errors or omissions, or nothing comes up or nothing happens that is going to harm you in the future. So that was another $685. That includes my OP1 filing, my BOC3 filing, my MCS150 filing to obtain my MC numbers and my DOT numbers. That's all included in that price, as well as the BOC3 filing. It took about 10 days from the time I filed that to the time I received the email confirmation that my application had been approved, accepted, and I was giving my DOT numbers and my MC number. A couple days after that, I filed my uniform carrier registration, my UCR, which is all brokers as of July 2020 are now required to have UCR filings. And then from there, I went and filed for my SCAT code, my SCAC code. And I filed my BMC 85, which is the $75,000 trust set up as a bond which you're required to have to be a broker for a carrier. It's $100,000 minimum bond or trust. Got that all set up. That was another $850 every quarter on that. I'm not going through all the numbers on this. I mean, I cover this all in another video on my channel on freight brokering, my official business channel. I'll leave a link to that below in the description for you guys if you want to check that out. It's a long video. It's a 2-hour long video. It's actually a movie on the process of becoming a freight broker and setting everything up. But yeah, it took me 30 days to the day from start to finish to obtain my brokerage authority. So I'm all good to go there. So a little bit of information about the business. The company name is MP Enterprises, LLC. The mailing address is 5432 East Northern Lights Boulevard, Suite 552, Anchorage, Alaska, 99508. The business phone number is area 907-313-8409. The business fax number is area 907-313-8408. The company's website is mpenterprises.us. That's mpenterprises.us. Did I just say .net? It's .us. It's mpenterprises.us. The general email address for the company is info@mpenterprises.us. I have a carrier-specific email, that's carrier@mpenterprises.us, as well as a shipper-specific email, which is shipper@mpenterprises.us. My DOT number is 352-7860. My MC number is 117-3367, and my SCAT code is MPEA. And I did set up a CCI, should go active by the end of the week. So I took on an additional $100,000 contingent cargo insurance. I don't need it as a broker, but it's still something good to have. It's something that shows that you're legitimate, and something I'm sure most shippers would appreciate you having. And in fact, some of them do require it. So anybody that's interested in becoming a carrier for me, or interested in having me ship some of your commodities, head on over to the website, download either the shipper agreement or the broker agreement, whichever one applies to you. Get it filled out, get it signed, get it back to me to your respective email addresses with the required information on those documents. So I can get you in the system, get you approved. I do use DAT, load board. And I am going to be setting up DAT onboarding later on this week to make it a little easier for carriers to come on. And I will be factoring all loads. Most loads will be paid within 24 hours of receiving all the documents from my carriers. That is your signed rate confirmation, your POD, your signed and prepared invoice, as well as any accessorial charges. As long as I have those by 10 a.m. Eastern day, I want them in by 10 p.m. Eastern time, Monday through Friday, to give me time to get everything collated and over to the factoring company. I use Axle Payments for my factoring. I need to have it to them by noon, Eastern time, Monday through Friday. They'll have everything processed and they'll start sending the payments out around 5 p.m. So some of you may receive payment same day, but for most of you, it will be the next day. For any shippers or carriers that are not already in the system, the first payment may take 3 to 5 days to process as all their information propagates through the system and gets set up properly. I'm basically doing quick pay to my carriers, and unlike other brokers, I will not be charging a fee. I know some brokers charge anywhere from 2 to 5% extra for quick pay. It's your money. I know some are going to say I'm an idiot, I'm walking away from money, and I'm stupid for doing this, but it's your money. You're doing the work. You deserve it. I'm not going to take anything away from you that I don't have to. All right, guys, I think I'm going to cut it there for now. There's not really much in review for this year as far as WFX goes. It's just driving, more driving, couple breakdowns, more drivings. I mean, typical truck driving stuff. All right, guys, that's it for now. Again, I hope this new year finds you all well. healthy, happy, and much wiser than we were last year. And until next time, keep it between the ditches, keep the shiny side up, the rubber side down. I'll see you out there on the road, and go Army, beat Navy.
Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.